Well, here's a request that came in by email. And this person starts out by saying, I hope you don't mind if I email you, but I'm not sure you would see my question if I put it on the comments of YouTube. I want to answer that. Yes, I will see your comments if you put them on YouTube. YouTube provides for us to see all comments, no matter how old the video was. All the comments, all the most recent comments, we will see together on YouTube. And I try to answer everything that I can. There have been cases when I I wasn't able to answer. But most of the time, I will answer your comments on YouTube. So don't be afraid they won't be seen. They will. But here's the question, she says. I hope you can answer. That is, can you explain the difference between RGB and CMYK? And why I need to know this stuff to mix color for my paintings? Yeah, I have a good bit to say about that. The best way to approach this is that this is a language. RGB is a language. CMYK is a language. And the color wheel is a language. Three different languages, each serving a specific purpose. Neither one of them work to interpret the other. The RGB, you're familiar with all this. RGB is the color language that allows us to see things on our screens, on your computer screen, on your phone screen, on your TV screen. That is the system that's used for that. And it's a matter of distributing little tiny color dots. I'm not going to go into the theory of it because you can Google that and find out for yourself. So that's the RGB. The CMYK is a language used for printing color. And still, the same thing is true. It's the way the color is mixed, or the way the ink is mixed. It's only works with ink. It's the way the ink is mixed, and that too you can Google and get a comprehension of what it's all about. The color wheel, we might call this YRB, yellow, blue, and red. Now, I know that there are people on YouTube that say yellow, blue, and red are not your primary colors. I'm going to show you that they are. And I heard or saw one short on YouTube that said, well, when your teachers were teaching you that yellow, red, and blue were primary colors, they were lying to you. They were not. Now I'm going to show you that. As I said before, none of these can be used to interpret the other. So as far as what you need to know for mixing your colors in painting, you don't need to know this, you don't need to know this, you do need to know this. Now, if you're going to do digital painting, if you're going to do your painting on a computer, as many artists are these days, you do need to know this. But because this won't work with the digital creation of color. Well, I want to show you why these don't work. So we'll start out with the digital. According to this, the digital way, the way it works is called an additive, and it's all about light, how light works. All color works because of the way the relationship of color comes out from the white light through a prism into this, what we call the spectrum of color, and here it is. All three of these work on that principle. It's just that the digital works with the light itself. The printing works with a subtractive method, and Google that. But the painting or the color wheel works with the relationship, the way these are formed in a circle, relationship of all these colors in a circle. And that's why we can mix those with pigment. So the difference here is pigment for these. Pigment is used here, ink is used here, light is used there. So three different languages. Now I want to show you a brief demonstration on why these don't work for a painter. So if we use this one first, according to this one, if we mix red and green, we should get yellow, because that's what this means here. And if we mix blue and red, we should get, well, if we mix all of these, of course, we get white. That's the theory. All right, so if we mix green and blue, we get what I call green-blue or blue-green, but the generic term is the cyan. All right, so let me show you that. So according to this, here's red right here. Okay, I'm going to get my, just want to show this how it works. Pull all the red out of the brush, and here's green right here. Now, according to that, if I mix this into this, I should get this, according to what this says. Pigment won't work that way, and here's why. I'm going to pull some red and some green together and mix them, and you can watch me mix them right here. And you see, there's the mixture. That is not yellow, but it works with light. It does not work with paint. So, and I'll show you just the one more there, which I think is sort of interesting. According to that, we should be able to mix green and blue and get cyan. All right, here's green. So we'll just put this one right here. Rinse the brush out real good. And squeeze the brush out real good. Here's blue right here. Now we'll mix those together to see what we get. So we mix green and blue. We're going to get green blue. So I'll try to get it in between. We get this right here. Now that has a kinship with cyan, but it doesn't give us the pure cyan. Now let me show you. The pure cyan is really, well, let me just show it to you. So I'm going to pull some white here, and here's my cyan. Now that, in the painter's language, is blue-green, but here it is right there. And of course, that's lighter. If you get a little darker, you can see, very much akin. So we know that if we mix now, if we try to use these, the theory there is that these are the primary colors, and then the other colors are the result of it. So go now to the printing, CMYK. There are a lot of painters now and artists who are going with that language, cyan, magenta, and yellow, and calling those the primary colors. In ink, they are the primary colors. But in painting, let's see the results of those. All right, so according to this, if the primary colors are yellow and magenta, they should produce red. All right, we'll get some yellow down here. Now, magenta is a generic name. So here's yellow. Magenta is a generic name. The real color name, or hue name for magenta, is red violet. So if you're saying red violet, you can be registering any hue that is red violet with more red in it, or red violet with more blue in it. And so that is a tertiary color. That's the way tertiary colors behave. But magenta is a single hue, a single registration of hue. Now, I have here my red violet, which is quinacridone violet. And so I'm going to mix some white with it here. And see, that is very much akin to what registers as magenta, but not quite. So we'll just put that right here. Now, let's mix this with yellow and see what we get. We'll just give it a true mix right here. Let's see what we get. Rather than a pure red, when we mix it with yellow, we're going to get more of a desaturated red, like this. See the difference? I can add more yellow. Still not getting red. Add more yellow. And we just keep getting that. Go back and add more magenta. So you're not going to get a pure red with those two colors. So how can that be primary? With paint. With paint. So that there's one there. Okay, now the other one here, according to this, if we mix magenta and cyan, we should get blue. That's pure blue they're talking about there. Okay, let's give that a try and see if that works. All right, so I'll pull. Well, let's get those so that you can see them. Now, let's see, be sure I have a cyan here. You're going to ask what color is that? Somebody's going to ask me what tube color is that, and I'll tell you, there it's pretty close, you see. What I did with my tube colors to get that is that I used the phthalo green, and I mean, I used the phthalo blue in Rembrandt Viridian. So I just put a little bit of Rembrandt Viridian into phthalo blue, and that gives me cyan. So I don't need a tube of that. But here it is, right here. See, it's pretty akin to that. All right, so you've got the magenta there, but we'll put magenta aside just to keep the experiment going pure. So magenta, I would need one that's not mixed with a yellow now to make this work, to make my experiment work. So we'll pull some of this down. I may not have enough there. Well, maybe so. Okay, maybe so. Let's see. Well, that's close. Now what happens when we mix those two together? I'll just come right in here, show you what happens when we mix those two together. In any direction I'm going to be fair now. I'm going to try to get blue out of that. Just try my best to get, we're speaking of a pure blue, not a blue that has another color in it. So we try this one. Well, there's a gray blue. It's not that blue. All right, let's do, put a little bit of more, put a little bit more of that magenta in there. Let's be fair now. That makes it a little bit darker, what I did just there. Pull a little bit more of the blue in there. Well, that's the desaturated blue, but it's not this blue. So you see, the best way for you to conclude these things on your own is to do just what I did. If someone tells you that something other than these are the primary colors, well, then test it out with your paint and find out for yourself. Now, the miracle, and you've seen me do many, many quick tips and many, many demonstrations on color, on what color does to color. The pigments that we use are what give us these colors. The pigments for oil paint, the pigments for acrylic, for watercolor, for pastels, for gouache, casein. Those are the major paints that artists use. Those pigments give us these. The various combinations of pigments, natural pigments, and synthetic pigments will give us these. And that gives us the start. We can always depend upon a pure yellow and a pure red and a pure blue giving us those mixtures. Now, there's one more myth I want to dispel before I close this out. A lot of people will say, well, yellow and blue won't give you green. That's because they've got the wrong yellow and the wrong blue. Now, there are many degrees of yellow and many degrees of blue, or shall we say many variations of yellow. We're talking about, when we say yellow, as a primary color, we mean yellow as it registers on the spectrum or on the color wheel. It's the yellow that's got more yellow hue in it than any other color or any other hue. So here we go. So what is it they say? They say that blue and yellow won't give you green. All right, here's my blue. Now this blue, cobalt blue, for blues in the pigments, is about as close to what we call spectrum blue as you can get. This is very close to cobalt blue here. All right. And then I've got yellow here, which is very, very close, as you can see, very, very close to spectrum yellow. I let the computer give the pure colors on these. These I got from online. All right, so here we go, pulling that blue in there, and pulling that blue in there, and, oh, I didn't put, well, it doesn't matter. So what we're looking for, making sure I have a clean brush, what we're looking for here is green. I believe that might be a green. And we, of course, depends on the whether it's yellow green or blue green. Depends on the amount of yellow you put in it. And let's put just a little bit more yellow in there and show you how that continues to give us green. All right, so those folks that argue that blue and yellow will give you green, email me. That is the best I can do now to show you the difference between among these systems and why, as a painter, you don't need to know anything about the RGB, not for painting. You don't need to know anything about CMYK, not for painting. It helps to know this stuff, and it's fun to find out about it. And the idea that we have three different languages that can interpret color is just absolutely fascinating. And from that viewpoint, you might want to check it out. But as far as the way the whole thing works, nothing beats YRB.
Be sure and view all of our quick tips. And while you're doing so, subscribe to the channel, click on the bell, so you'll always get a notice when we produce a new quick tip, which is every week. And if you have a question, leave it in the comments section and we'll make a quick tip for you. Also, take a trip over to DianneMize.com, where I have full-length lessons, downloads, DVDs, lots of other stuff there, some free stuff for you. And while you're there, you can subscribe to the newsletter, and that way you'll always be informed every time we do something new.